What is up, everyone? Welcome and or welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new, welcome. My name is Mara. Thank you guys so much for stopping by. If you don't know, I like to grow long, healthy, natural hair on this channel. If you guys don't know, I am past hip length. I am down to like the butt area. So definitely be sure to subscribe. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Make sure you give it a like. Make sure you share it. Make sure you follow me on IG right there because I will be posting a little bit more. But let's just get right into this video because as you can see, we have a mess here. Pretty much, this is a 2-week-old wash and go. It's not too bad, to be honest with you. It's not bad. I've had worse for 2 weeks, but this is my 2-week-old wash and go. So I did my hair 2 Saturdays ago. So it wasn't last week when I did my hair, but I did it the week before. So it's pretty old. And today I'm just going to be showing you guys how I restyled this wash and go to hopefully be something a little bit more decent. Now y'all know my struggle with braid outs, twist outs, flat twist. I'm making the executive decision to try another flat twist out. So I think I know what my mistake was when trying to do flat twists. I feel like I had the concept of braiding when you grab 2 pieces when you do the next braid, and I feel like I was doing that with twists. I don't know, I probably just made that up. But yeah, without further ado, let's just get right into this video.
Alright y'all, so first things first, we're gonna go ahead and part our hair. You know it's always easier to work in sections, so once you have that hair parted semi down the middle, we're gonna put the other half up, and then we're gonna get to work with putting that moisture back into our hair. Right now I'm using only water, and that is mainly just to try to get my hair to separate and without any tangles. And then I also use my yall leave-in conditioner spray. I use the spray because it is much more easier to kind of like control where that goes, because like I told you guys, my hair was dry, so with my hair being dry, it was kind of a little bit more knotted than normal. So that leave-in conditioner actually works to get those knots out. But once we do detangle with our tangle teaser brush, we're gonna go ahead and just start twisting. And like I said, doing the twist this time around, it was much easier because I don't know what kind of concept I had before, but the last time I feel like I definitely did it wrong, but this time it was much better. All right, so like the first twist, we're gonna keep that same energy. We're gonna go ahead, moisturize and condition, and then we're gonna get right into twisting. And as you guys can see, I am trying to zoom in a little bit, but with my pointer finger, I'm actually separating and grabbing the hair. And then with my other hand, I am putting it into the twist and twisting, if that made sense. I don't know if that made sense when I explained it, but if y'all watch very carefully, you should be able to see what I'm doing. But pretty much, like I said, we're just gonna go ahead, moisturize, condition, twist, and we're gonna do our whole head like that. And I forgot to tell y'all, I'm sitting here watching the video and doing the voiceover. I see the whole bucket of gel behind me in the video. And after I put my conditioner detangle, I actually go ahead with my Wet Lime Extreme Gel. And that was the last thing that I used before I went in with the twist.
Alright, so as y'all can see, this is my hair. This is how it came out. This is with all the twists. I think I have a total of 8 twists, but this is my hair, as y'all can see. This time it was much easier to twist my hair. I think I got it. Hopefully it comes out like I knew what I was doing, but we shall see. So I'm just gonna go ahead and let my hair dry. I probably use my blow dryer too, just so that way we can quicken up this process. And then once everything is dry, it needs to be 100% dry. Not 90, not 50, not 80. It needs to be 100% dry, just so that we can see what these results are looking like. Because down here, these twists look real good. Up here, they need a little work, but they still look good. But like I said, let's just go ahead and get this dried, and then I'm gonna come back to you guys to take them out. All right, so 3 days later and we are back. I literally just got off of work, my bad, but my hair, it is definitely dry. So we're gonna go ahead and take this loose, and we're gonna be using our trusty dusty oil. If you don't know, this is it, okay? This one is looking, the ends, it's real curly, and this is where normally this is where it goes wrong, this little part right here, because it gets tangled and knotted right here. We'll see. Ooh, okay. Are we're gonna take it very gently. I'm scared. Okay. It's always the connecting part that messes up and makes my hair frizzy because I have to end up pulling it loose. So let's see. I'm gonna start on another. This is stressing me out. We're gonna come back to that one because that's kind of getting tangled. Because at this point, I just want to rip through it and take it loose. But I'm trying to be like as gentle as I possibly can. So we're gonna see if this one's a little bit better. Alright, so this is my hair with all of the twists out. As y'all can see, it is still pretty defined. That's because I do have that gel. I use that gel in my hair, but it did get frizzy because y'all seen me struggle, okay?
Okay, so even more volume, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna unravel some of those little twisted parts a little bit more, just that way, like I said, we can have more volume. It'll still be defined, and we're also gonna work on defining some of the ends as well. How I'm doing that, I just simply put oil on my fingers and then just twirl my fingers in the direction that the curls is going at the end, just that way we can get those defined a little bit more.
So I'm pretty satisfied with this flat twist out. Again, this is what it looks like. I may fluff it at the roots as the day go on, but I'm probably not going to separate it any more than I did. If you know natural hair, when you go outside, it's gonna get a little bigger anyway. So if you guys like it, definitely be sure to give me a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe. And definitely be sure to share this video. Make sure you go ahead and check out my Instagram as well. I will link everything down below for you. So again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.